Hey everybody, this is Linda with Stamping School and Where the Rubber Hits the Road. I have been loving the corrugated paper. It's in the Stampin' Up! Annual Catalog, good till May 2016. And it's on page 148 up here at the top. Easy to miss. Doesn't look like much here, but you know I've been using it a lot if you've been following Stamping School or watching the blog. So you only get four sheets, two white and two of the craft color for $7, but you can do a lot with it because they're big sheets, they're 12 by 12. So for instance, the card that I'm gonna do today, you can get six cards out of just one of the sheets. So I'm gonna be using the natural craft color here. Well, I love the texture in this corrugated paper, but I was thinking how cool would it be if we could emboss it? So back at the end of June, I was in Florida for my team meeting and I showed this card and this technique. So I have been doing it ever since because I love trying different patterns. So here's the regular corrugated paper. And then this is what it looks like when you emboss it. Let me see if we can zoom in a little bit. It really looks like fabric and it feels like fabric. So you get all the extra ridges right here, but you also get the texture from the embossing folder. This one is done doing the boho chic paper. So what you wanna make sure first is that the back side of your folder is the raised side. In most cases, the Sizzix logo is on the front and the Stampin' Up! Logo is on the front of it and you can just put your ridges facing up. There are a few folders that are just weird that for some reason it's the opposite way, but if your backside here is raised, then it's gonna push that design up, so you should be good. So figure out where you wanna put this through and you run it through your embossing machine. And then you end up with this. Now, just so we can see the design a little bit better, and let me show you the card that we're doing. So this is the card. So I'm adding in some sponging on the top. I'm gonna do it with crumb cake. It would look really great with baked brown sugar. It would look really great, which is what I do with this one, is the old Encore ink pads, which we don't carry anymore, but the gold shimmer on it looks really nice. And what you wanna do is you wanna just barely kiss it. Barely, barely, barely. And if you wanna use a sponge dauber to be more precise, you can. But I mean, I am barely touching it. And I'm just burnishing it just a little bit on the raised dots because I don't want the whole thing. I don't want to pounce it or anything like that. All I want to do is just get those little images to pop up a little bit more. So very, very lightly. If I get too much ink on it, then it's going to look a little muddy. And I'm just trying to make those designs pop out. Okay, here's what it looks like when it's done. So maybe we can, so I'll zoom in a little bit here so you can see it a little bit closer. I'm gonna use the Fast Views on here just because it's pretty heavy with the embossing. Remember when you use your Fast Views, you pull down and you go right, and then the next time you pull down and go left, and then that way it doesn't get all icky on you. Okay, so we're gonna layer this on black. Get it nice and smooth. Isn't that just so cool? And I wish you could feel it. We need video feel-a-vision because it really does feel like fabric. I've got a piece of this bohemian paper that's gonna go right here on a little black layer. I think this paper is 1 inch and the paper behind it is 1¼. So we're just gonna put some of this Fast Views on the back. And then I'm gonna run some cord around it and then we'll put the greeting on. I'm gonna take some of this gold cord that we have from Stampin' Up! And I'm gonna put a little bit of Fast Views on the back. And I'm just gonna tack my end, one end over, wrap it around twice. And glue it down. And now I'm ready to attach it to the card. Still using the Fast Views on it just because it's going to be a little bit heavy. Putting it on Cajun Craze. Just liked all these colors together. I'm gonna take another piece of this little cord and just tie a knot on it. So rather than bring it around and try and tie it, it's just easier for me to do it that way. All right, last thing is the greeting. So for my greeting, I'm gonna use this cute one from Friendly Wishes. This is You're the Best. I stamped it in black, and then because of this little curve here, it just cried out to be cut with my oval framelits. So we're using oval framelit number 2 always start from the smallest one and work out. So one is the smallest. So we're using number two. Cutting that out, putting a couple dimensionals on the back. Just remember to put your dimensionals on the top and bottom if you've got the cord in the way. Otherwise, it'll be too bouncy and uneven. So put those here. And then we can finish it off with a couple of candy dots in the Cajun craze to kind of pull in from the card. And then on the inside, I just ran some more of that paper, stamped a greeting from the thanks set, and colored it in a little bit with my Cajun marker. So here's another option that I did. This is with the white corrugated paper. I'll lay it down to kind of zoom in so you can see it better. So you've got the lines of the corrugated paper going this way, and then this fun flower embossing folder over top of it. And I didn't want to hide this really cool texture, so I just added a little birthday guy up here just to keep it simple. I hope you try this corrugated crush technique, and let me know how it goes. We'll see you next time.